specific adaptation to impose demands. Everybody understands this with basic physiology. Specific adaptation to impose demands. Now, we're not going to get into the physiology of this. We're going to get into the philosophy of it. One of the biggest problems that we find as we teach this all over the world is every one of us, the majority of us, fall into this boat. We're all gym rats. And we fall under the trap of what we call the curse of the gifted. The majority of us are drawn to that gym rat mentality of whether you are just love playing a sport, you love working out, you love CrossFitting. How many of us, and don't raise your hand, how many of us stretch as much as you're supposed to stretch? I said, don't show off. He's like, No, think about how many of us do the things that we suck at. How many of us spend more time on fixing those tiny little quirks and habits and imbalances and instabilities? Or would all of us much rather do whatever we love? If you guys are good bench pressers, you're like, how many of you guys have ever been like, you know what? I'm not going to do an extra set of bench press. I'm going to go stretch. Yeah, exactly. None of us do that. If you love running, you'll never give up running. If you love squatting, you'll never give up squatting, but you will give up those little things. So when we talk about that specific adaptation to impose demands, remember what your end goal is. All of this. If your end goal to develop your athletes is to make them a better athlete, to give them a better opportunity to succeed on the field, then you always have to come back to the type of demands that I'm imposing on my athletes. Whatever that is. Whatever it is you feel that they need, make sure that you are imposing those demands on them, no matter what it is. If my job is to put up big numbers on the board, but that doesn't translate to on-field performance, there's something wrong with what I'm doing as a professional. And it really opened us up to say, hey, how do we change this? How do I get somebody's lifts to translate to on-field performance? And so my answer to that, and all of you guys learn from my mistakes, is yes, I think there's a careful balance between maintaining somebody's enthusiasm. But understand, it is nowhere near as bad as the disappointment that an athlete, not general population, that an athlete is going to experience when they come to you and they say, hey, my 10 muscle ups didn't help me score that game-winning touchdown. Those air squats that I did not help me make that game-saving tackle. And you're going to have to live with that. As you sit there and say, hey, well, you know, and then you're going to come up with some BS idea about, okay, work capacity and blah, 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 but understand the end result is still on-field performance. On-field performance. So everybody that has the responsibility and the accountability of training athletes know 100% in your heart of hearts that it is on-field performance.